know it's working when you shake this thing up. And if you have a bunch of gold floating around, well, that means the gold's starting to slurf off the electronic scrap cards.
Boy, gold does get everywhere if you're not careful. Look at that. Just in the process of filtering off this stuff the first time, I did collect quite a bit of gold. It needs to be washed with HCl, boiling HCl actually, to get a little bit more of the copper out of it before I start digesting the gold. But we'll get there. Now whenever I have filters, I just stuff the whole filters in, paper and all. Here, once you get this to start boiling, just go ahead and turn the heat off. Let it cool. I'll actually let it settle like that. I'll pop it up in that position somewhere, and then I can pour the acid off. I'll just pour the acid into the rest of the other stuff. I'll pour a little gold with it, no big deal. There's already gold in the process bucket anyway. Okay, so now we're ready to dissolve the gold. We have all this gold in there. Looks good. This is foils. We're just going to dissolve a batch here and filter it. So, add regular hydrochloric acid from swimming pool supply store, like so. And then we add some regular Clorox bleach, regular unscented Clorox bleach, just a few drops. Whoa, got a little extra. Gonna put a watch glass over that. Hold that down. Get all our gold swished around in there. It's gonna be releasing chlorine gas, so take this outside. Maybe add a little bit more bleach to it. I may let it sit for a while and see how much I can get it to dissolve here. Let it sit overnight or something like that. Those foils are very, very thin, so it won't take too long to dissolve. Okay, cold weather is a good time to do this. It helps the chlorine stay in solution, not bubble out. So this has been I'm just gonna let it sit for a few hours. I actually added a little bit more HCl and Clorox to give it a little bit more volume. Just maybe a few little flakes of gold floating around in there still, but mostly it's just the paint and little plastic fragments that got caught up in there. And I'll let this sit overnight, stir it around a little bit more in the morning, and then filter it off. Then I'll have a nice clean gold solution. A little bit of a green tint, which indicates probably the presence of a little bit of copper left. That's to be expected. That's what the last steps for refining it are going to be to handle. Yeah, keeping things wiped down is really handy to use this paper towel. So everywhere that you wipe up, you want to wipe it up and save what you wipe up. These paper towels can be easily thrown down into another batch eventually that is just for washing out any gold solution that ends up in these paper towels. It's just a little windy outside for my highly sophisticated filtering system. This consists of a mouthwash bottle, which be sure to relabel that, because it may look like mouthwash when we're all done. It'll look like gold mouthwash. So a little painter's tape and the end of a vodka, or the tip of a vodka bottle, plastic, and a coffee filter. Not much to it. Not rocket science, folks, here. Just gonna pour it in the top. Oh, and I have paper towels underneath in case I do have a little spill. When you're doing processes like this, stuff gets everywhere. Just checking down in there to see if I have any floaties. I won't throw the material that's in here away for a while. It'll get processed in, because it looks like like maybe there's one or two flakes in there that could still be some gold. So I'll run it through a few times to make sure all the gold is dissolved out of here before I throw anything away. And you see when it comes through the filter, it looks pretty. It looks like mouthwash, actually. I don't know if this was such a good choice to use, but I will label it poison. Thank you.